Liverpool owner Jochen Dublo Henrys told his apology is too little too late, his words are hollow. And his FSG group is arrogant in a scathing statement from the Spirit of Sankli fans group on his Super League crocodile tears. Liverpool fans group Spirit of Sankli has released a scathing statement. Hitting out at the club's owners for throwing everyone under the bus by signing up to the European Super League. Fenway Sports Group, founded by Jochen Dublo Henry, agreed to join the controversial breakaway project on Sunday alongside 11 other clubs. Including Premier League rivals Manchester United, Manchester City, Chelsea, Arsenal and Tottenham. The European Super League announcement sparked outrage within the football world, but after backlash from fans as well as resistance from players. Managers and pundits, the Premier League's Big Six all withdrew from the project on Tuesday night. Henry apologized to Liverpool fans, manager Jurgen Klopp and the players on Wednesday morning, but the supporters group told him it was too little too late in a fierce statement. It has been a tumultuous, sickening few days for us all. Spirit of Sankli have always asked for honesty, integrity and transparency from club owners FSG. But the arrogance and deception they have shown behind this money grab is frightening. But not surprising, their statement later on Wednesday read: "We have noted Jochen Henry's apology, but this PR exercise is too little too late. These crocodile tears will not wash. Actions speak louder than hollow words. Liverpool Football Club is not an American franchise, it is a community steeped in history and tradition. The future of football came crashing down in 48 hours because of the solidarity and outcry of legacy fans across the country. This debacle must be a catalyst for a real change, not an exercise in damage limitation. Our owners have thrown everyone under the bus, supporters, manager, players and staff, and humiliated themselves through sheer greed and arrogance. The hypocrisy of the Premier League and broadcasters has also been noted. They have never considered the fans in their own gold rush and have treated us with thinly disguised contempt over the years. We need a fundamental change in football governance, one that is fair for the whole football pyramid, not just the rapacious elite. We need a model that promises equitable distribution of the vast amounts of money involved in the beautiful game, our game. D During this confusion, UEFA have gladly portrayed themselves as the progressive force. Nothing could be further from the truth, and their new Champions League format is a disgrace. One that must be resisted immediately. We will be consulting with our members to gauge their opinion on our next steps. Harry issued a groveling apology for the disruption I caused due to the club's involvement as a founder member of the now collapsed Super League. After 2 days of silence as widespread anger and fury erupted across Europe at the Super League proposals, Harry finally appeared in a video message and said, "I want to apologize to all the fans and supporters of Liverpool Football Club for the disruption I caused over the past 48 hours. It goes without saying but should be said that the project put forward was never going to stand without the support of the fans. No one ever thought differently in England. Over these 48 hours you were very clear that it would not stand. We heard you. I heard you.